way a couple of months ago. It brought to our attention that Drama Club wanted to do a certain play coming up in March, at the end of the year.
Beginning of June.
Okay, beginning of June. And the actual play had a lot of foul language in it. And a couple of months ago, we said that we were not happy with that, to amend the play. So the play was amended, so we have to discuss what we're going to do.
You might come to the podium?
Sure.
So I do realize that you left some of the words in there, and you had a meeting to leave some of those words in there. So we have, so we can just... All right, so how many F-bombs are in there?
Two.
Two F-bombs. How many B-bombs?
None.
Oh, okay, so you took, I'm going to say, so you took bullshit out?
Yes.
Okay.
There's one regular S. The main concern I have with the show is F-bombs.
I can't hear. We can't hear her.
Sorry. There are 16 in total. I went through the entire play and saw which ones I thought we could keep the emotion behind the line with while taking that out, and other lines was kind of integral to what the character was trying to say and express. So only two lines had that work.
Okay, so two F.
Yeah, how many total curse words are there?
You have five green stickers.
Actually, I have got rid of these I put on the inside of the page. I have more to make them, but I did like a first draft of the stickers, and then I did a second draft of the stickers, and I took them out. So the green ones I'm keeping in purple, the ones I'm removing, and it's the two sticking out on the side that I'm actually keeping, the ones on top of.
Okay, so let me get this straight. How many lead? How many are staying in the play?
Two Fs. One D and one S.
So you took it down significantly?
Yes.
Okay.
I wouldn't come to you again if I didn't know. I think it's very important to embrace the arts. And I came into the high school, we did projects on censorship and how that's not okay because it's important to the message of a piece. And I still firmly believe that, especially in performing arts. So I think it's going to be an amended version in hopes that that would be brought down.
So if it proved, again, I can't speak for the board, but if it proved, what measures would you have in place so that your audience that, you know, attends this will be aware that there could be a few words?
Well, on all of the flyers and tickets and any posters printed from the school, it would say explicit language included to be aware. We don't usually get any extreme age audiences. We usually don't get younger kids. We usually don't get senior citizens unless they're family members of people in the cast. So I think everybody can agree, most high school students. I mean, in most of our required reading, it has explicit language, which is why I thought it was rather appropriate for the audience, because I did read this in my AP English class. But all the flyers that would be put up in public and on the announcements of school would say that there's explicit language.
All right, so Mr. Garcia, have you come across this in your line of work about using, you know, certain words in plays?
Yes.
And your thoughts?
Board of Education has the right to make a decision.
Okay, do you know any other districts that have allowed the kids to use their creative use of words?
I don't personally, but that doesn't mean it hasn't happened. This is a policy decision.
Okay, so are we expected to vote on this tonight?
We need to start paying for the rights and moving forward with auditions and preparation of play.
Was this brought to Mr. Costa in the last couple of months?
No, it was not. We went directly to Adams and the board to get the entire community's view about the school. But I'd be more than happy to do that.
I would just be interested to feel like Mr. Costa felt about it, what certain teachers maybe that are involved thought about it.
I have spoken to
because it's, you know, for me, I can have my own opinion, but who really cares about my opinion? Mm-hmm. I it's
I've spoken to a few teachers and students.
The people that are involved, really, you know, me personally, I don't think it's right, but that's just me.
I was going to start a petition to get to show who's involved. In AP, my major competition this year, last year I was in the literature competition, and both of my English teachers loved the show. People are constantly asking me if we're involved in the drama club, have you gotten approved yet, which obviously I had to say no, but I wasn't aware that I was allowed to bring people to support it. I had a swim team did, otherwise I would have brought people who also believe this is important to not have to choose overwork.
Who was the gentleman that you wrote last time?
Mr. Francella. He is, he produces the drama club. He had an outside director, so he was also at the show.
My question would be, at this point, she has to get an answer. So, if Mr. Costa doesn't have a problem, they're just building. I don't have a problem. That's my vote.
I don't have a problem.
I don't have a problem.
I agree. If Mr. Costa's okay with it, the teachers are okay with it. They're the ones that should make the decision.
And Mr. Costa, can you
so
reach
I'm
out
okay
to
with
him
it also.
And let him reach out to superintendent, and then because I'll go along with what Mr. Costa says, because I can see that you put a lot of work into this, and Mr. Costa made that decision, because I'll stand behind his decision, and hopefully he says yes.
I'll stand by his decision. Just to make it clear, as much as I respect Mr. Costa and the teachers of Connecticut High School, I cannot approve it.
Thank
you.
And I will contact you through Mr. Cortisella.
Okay. Thank you so much for the time.
Thank you for coming. Thank you.
Keep pursuing your dream, because I heard that you're a wonderful actress, so.